just before 8. Oh, that looks good.
Did you used to do those when you were a little girl? Yeah, well, now it's half. It's like computer thingied. And so that's
I always
thing,
used to watch The Incredible Hulk when I was a little girl.
Did you do the noises? Because I used to do them. Like, sometimes I'd go and when I'd go to bed at night and I'd sit down on my bed and I'd go...
You would have been old. Something. How old is The Incredible Hulk?
Oh, I'm talking about last week. Anyway, we'll talk about that because what's happened with The Incredible Hulk has been redone many, many times, and each time they redo him, he gets bigger.
He does, doesn't he?
And I think that's what has to happen nowadays. You've got to make things bigger to make them more exciting.
The north of the country. Friday sees those fronts affecting the bottom of the South Island and Taranaki as well. And it's a similar story in the South Island for Saturday, with showers affecting Auckland all the way up to Kaitaia. That's news and weather and sport and everything. Paul, Pippa, how are you?
Good,
do some work, please.
It's like the old days when you used to do everything, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, I know, but you can do it now, please.
Remember, you used to do the whole lot. We were just sitting here watching you doing the weather there, and you go like this. When you start reading the weather, you're sitting like this, talking to the TV, and you go like this. Chat, chat, chat. And you do the weather like that, and then you come up like this.
Oh, you were very relaxed.
What's that all about?
Very chilled.
Well...
What kind of freakish behaviour is that?
Not freakish behaviour, it's just sort of having a cruisy, laid-back lifestyle, no pressure and hopes.
All right, that's
just
good.
Sinking into the
I'm
river.
Sure there's much more to it than that. Now, talking of much more to it, how do you get salmonella from fresh tomatoes? Mm. Where does it come? How do you get it? They're fresh tomatoes.
Oh, I don't know. Maybe there's something in the toxic sprays that have gone on the tomatoes. Who knows?
It's weird,
I ain't a scientist, I'm afraid.
It's weird. I suppose it could just be some of those Hispanic people that pick them.
Oh, come on, Paul.
Well, no, they could be... No.
I've got Joris
don't
de Brez on the phone for you, Paul.
Of...
Joris, did he pick tomatoes?
Joris.
No, maybe they do carry salmonella tomatoes.
What's this got to do with Joris?
Well, he's the Race Relations Commissioner. I think that was not a particularly
I'm
nice statement to make, Paul.
No. It's just they have a lot of Hispanic people who pick tomatoes. No,
if I were you, Paul, I'd
don't.
Put that spade away to stop digging now.
I'm sorry.
Oh,
I call
goodness.
It as I see it. And if you're Hispanic, you pick tomatoes. That's, I mean, you do other things as well. Some of them are running huge corporations, I expect. Tomato Corporation. No, seriously, they make that. It's only because, you know, they just pick tomatoes in season.
Are you embarrassed?
The point you're making, I'm beyond embarrassed, actually, Peter, but hey, only one more day.
No,
the point you're trying to make inappropriately is that perhaps it had something to do with the processing of the tomatoes between fields and shop as opposed to salmonella being inherent in the tomato makeup.
Tell Peter.
Yeah.
Tell him that.
Right, okay, sorry about that. Apologies to everybody.
Put your pens down.
Stop tapping away. 14 minutes into the program. Very sorry for everyone we've offended so far this morning. Corin has more bad news.
I'm afraid
Thank you very much, Corin. I was just telling Pippa. What? I just said to Pippa, I said there won't be any Hispanic people watching anyway. She said they'll be too busy picking tomatoes. But the fact of the matter is, I'm a gypo. We can only dream of being Hispanic, you know. Hispanics sit around after they pick big tomatoes and they laugh about gypsies. That's what they do.
When are you going?
We tell gypsy jokes is what they do.
All
right, let's look at history. Did you ever have a Meccano set? Peter, you would have had a Meccano set.
Yes, I did, Paul.
Yeah, those little bolts. And those bent bits, which there were never enough of the bent bits, Pippa.
I never had Meccano.
No,
he's a Lego
you're too
girl.
Young. You're too young. Because Lego came in.
But Meccano's back, though.
Yeah, well, because it's one of those classy toys from Meccano. I remember my dad bringing home this huge set, huge box of Meccano, and he sat me down on the carpet, and I had to watch him as he built a cable car from one end of the living room to the other. And as I went to bed, he said to me, "If you get up before me in the morning, do not touch the cable car." And it sat there for maybe 3 weeks, then he put it in the box and put the box away too high in the wardrobe for me to be able to reach.
Oh, that's awful. That's cool. Very sad about Zara Phillips, too.
Mm.
I think that's disappointing, isn't
it? Well, it's sad about her horse more than her. Yeah.
Well,
she'll have another chance. Maybe the horse won't.
Poor Toy Town.
Yeah,
anyway, let's
horse,
go...
Peter. It's just a horse.
Oh, for God's sake, Paul. What sort of form are you in this morning? I mean, the sooner you leave this place, the better.
Well, there, he said it, hasn't he?
He said it. Everyone's been wanting to say it. Peter said it. Let's go to Tamati now and find out what the weather's doing.
Person, but a passenger. Does your friend need a lift home?
Yeah, possibly, Paul. Would you like to take her, her home with
it's,
you?
Yeah. Yeah, well,
she's
it's
nice
a good,
and quiet.
It's a good excuse you have now for the blow-up doll you travel around with in your car, isn't it? You could just say, transit lane. Great.
Yes, Pippa. maybe I could get another one. I could maybe get away with two.
Right, thank you so much, Amy. Let's go down to the Capitol now.
Tell you a funny story. Shall I tell you a funny story?
Yeah, here we go.
What is that?
I'm sorry, Maddie. Here we go.
I said, here we go.
Yeah.
Come
and
on,
you,
hurry
and
up.
And you
what
rolled your eyes and flicked your head.
What
You've
is
been
that?
In television for 15 minutes, and you're saying, here we go to an A-lister.
A-lister.
Well, oh. Rate yourself. Oh, rate yourself. A-lister.
Let's just keep
really?
The camera on Maddie for a moment. You're
A-lister.
In my sights, Maddie. You're in my... Anyway, let me tell you this yarn, right?
It.
I was
okay.
a little boy, and I went to Singapore to see my father, mm-hmm. right? So he put me up in this really, really flash hotel. And so I was just lying on the bed looking up, as you do in a really, really flash hotel. And there was like a really, not like our ceiling here with all these lights. It was like a really flashy sort of, you know, fretted ceiling, you know, like a beautiful old-fashioned ceiling. And in the middle of it, there was like a light fitting that wasn't, I was just young, there was like a light fitting that wasn't properly put together. And I thought, oh, I wonder what that is. I'll give it a poke. And so I stood on the bed and I couldn't reach it. So I got a chair. And I positioned the chair on
the bed,
climbed on the chair, stuck my finger up in the socket and all this water came down. And I thought, shit, shit, shit. And I quickly took the chair down. I was completely saturated. I quickly took the chair down and actually put the chair away, laid back down on the bed with all this water coming down, thinking it'll be right. Everything will be all right.
Did anyway, you think it was meant to happen?
Well, no, but I thought it'll stop in a minute. Surely to God, there can't be this much water in Singapore. Anyway, next minute, there's this panicked knock on the door. Bang, 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 bang on the door. So I thought, oh, I better make it look like I don't know what's going on. I'm now completely saturated. The whole room. So I get out, I go to the door, and this woman says, quick, we're evacuating the hotel. I said, oh, what's wrong? What's wrong? I get out, we have to rush down the stairs because they'd shut all the lifts down and everything like that.
Well, all the sprinklers going?
Only on that floor.
Oh, only on that floor?
Only on that floor. So I get down there and I'm in the lobby and everyone's going, God, what's happened? What's happened? And so I go, God, what's happened? What's happened? What's happened? Is there a fire on the floor? God, I could have been killed.
And so you never owned up to it?
And my father came home and I said, oh, there was a huge
you,
lot
you
of...
Were there, how old were
there
you?
There was a kerfuffle today in the hotel room, Dad. I said, should have been here. I don't know where the fire was, but the sprinklers went. The whole place has been ruined. We had to be moved to another floor. It was huge. Anyway, the moral of this tale is do not put a chair on the bed, stand on the chair and stick your finger...
Prods the sprinkler.
...in the... Because I didn't know it was a sprinkler. I just thought it was an electrical socket or something. Anyway,
don't do that either.
How easy is that?
Brilliant advice. Great story. Thank you for that. Well,
thanks,
after the break, we're going to the movie. Series, and he used to compete with Schwarzenegger in the Mr. Universe
and
comps.
He does. Keep an eye out for him because he does appear in the film as well.
Oh, yeah. There's a little cameo.
There's a little cameo and he does a few sound.
All right, Francesca,
okay.
Please. 2 months' time. All right, some comments this morning about Hispanics. Thinking, well, just not thinking, perhaps, but certainly thinking there wouldn't be any Hispanics watching. How wrong was I? Paul, just wanted to ask you not to generalise on your comments, as I'm a Mexican and do watch your programme. Actually, you are the one that I really love to watch, so it did hurt a bit, your comments, that is. Just please do not keep generalising, as there are people like me that love you and feel hurt when you make comments like that. So how do we know this person is Hispanic? Because of the last line.
Because they told
Thank you, Peter and Peepa. Is what it says. Hey, no, seriously, thank you for that. And here's another one. Who would have
if
thought?
If it makes you feel any better, I mean, by the time Paul's finished, he does manage to offend every sector of society. I mean, no one is left out.
It's fairly sprinkled. This one here, Hispanics are watching. Fantastic. And we are not pleased with the racist commentary. We deserve an apology. You know, as I pointed out before, I am part of the most persecuted race in the world. If anyone knows about persecution, it's us
Jippos. I don't know if that's an excuse. That is not an excuse to treat others
poorly. No, it's not really, is it? It's not really, is it? All right, this all stems from salmonella in tomatoes. the issue may be due to animal fecal residue in the water used to irrigate tomato fields. And this one here says, Paul is sort of right. Years ago, the USA had an outbreak of salmonella in parsley that was traced to filthy water in Mexico. I'm sorry. That's what they say. Now, this is interesting too. You know the carpooling? The issue of the dog being a passenger was confronted in the US in Seattle 25 years ago, along with blow-up dolls. They were both tossed out of court. The best confrontation of the carpool law was a woman who was pregnant. And she argued that she had another, and that was tossed out of court too. I feel sorry for your critics, Paul. They obviously have no sense of humour. I wouldn't call you arrogant, just an imp. Imp is quite nice. So, there you go. Thank you very much for all of your comments.